March 1st, 1932. Charles Lindbergh and his wife, Anne, are settled in for the evening. The nanny makes her final check on Charles Jr., Lindbergh's 20-month-old toddler, nicknamed the Eaglet. When she notices an open window, she rushes to close it before the baby catches a chill, but then notices that the crib is empty. The Eaglet is gone. In the child's room, investigators find two critical clues: a chisel and a ransom note demanding $50,000. And on the estate grounds, the police find a ladder broken into three pieces. A Wisconsin wood expert named Arthur Kaler urges New Jersey police to let him help solve the Lindbergh baby kidnapping case by examining the wooden ladder used in the abduction. They send off slivers of the ladder to Arthur Kaler at the federally funded Forest Products Laboratory in Madison, Wisconsin. He instructs New Jersey police to search every single lumber yard in the area for wood samples. Investigators search over 1,500 lumber yards. They haul countless samples to Kaler, who uses the most sophisticated tools of the day to compare each and every piece to the wood in the ladder used in the kidnapping.
To the average eye, we're not going to understand the difference in lumber. But he was able to figure out to the 100th of an inch what this lumber looked like.
They're surprised when he was actually able to make a match, and they're able to trace the wood to the National Lumber and Millwork Corporation in the Bronx.
It's a short-lived victory.
Once they found the lumberyard, it was a dead end because there were no receipts leading to anybody that was involved. They knew where the lumber, part of the lumber came from, but beyond that, they weren't able to follow up.
But detectives may not have to worry about the wood evidence after all, when a break in the case changes the entire course of the investigation. Almost a year after the ransom was paid in traceable gold certificates, one of the notes has just been used.
When they went to investigate, they were able to check the registration and found that it belonged to Bruno Richard Hauptmann.
Bernard Hauptmann, 34, is a carpenter with a previous criminal record for robbery in his native Germany.
Arthur Kaler tells police, when you're doing your investigation of this suspect's home, look for any missing wood to be the final piece of this kidnap ladder.
Incredibly, when they search Hauptmann's house, they find a floorboard is missing. Kaler takes rail 16 from the ladder, puts it right in the hole in Hauptmann's floor, and it fits perfectly.
The wood evidence was one of the nails in Hauptmann's coffin.
Hauptmann is found guilty and sentenced to death.